And then there were the seals, just so beautiful. It's something that just fills your soul.
We spent about 5 days camping on the ice. And all around you is the sound of splashing water and little seals going, ma, ma, ma.
Get to Mars missiles. Grid position. These vessels have 20 sealers and a fishery officer on board.
In the background, you have a giant freighter, a brilliant red freighter. And coming towards you is a phalanx of sealers. These are guys dressed in heavy khaki canvas clothes and boots and black goggles, walking forward. It's just this machine walking through. And I couldn't keep up with it. I couldn't go through the ice with my equipment as fast as they could go through killing seals. So finally, I did the only thing I could do. I found a little seal pup that was away. And I set my camera up in front of it, right down low at the seal level, and got my exposures, got my focus, got everything set up on the off chance that a guy would come up and kill it. And the guy walked straight up, straight up, straight up. Totally ignored me. Just crushed its head in with the club, flipped it over, and I'm doing catching this all on camera. Took out his knife, took a couple of passes on a sharpening stone, cut the two arteries to make sure it was dead, and he looked at me, and he said, in a thick Newfoundland accent, "There's some things a man should never do." And then went off to the next seal. He didn't want to be there any more than I did, or the seal did.
In 1995, we knew the hunt was starting up again, but there was no way to just get footage of it, and it was happening too far away, and the sealers were too much on guard.
AJ decided to take the campaign in a new direction.
Try to get onto sealing ships and get footage. We would send crews out undercover.
The idea was to catch sealers breaking the law.
These were the undercover glasses that we used on a number of different occasions. This was pretty state-of-the-art stuff for 1996, 1997, around there. But you have to remember that at that point, nobody had seen the hunt since the late 80s. So what these undercover crews were able to do is really blow the lid off of what was happening.
AJ operated with a new slogan. It's not just cruel, it's criminal.
It was pretty shocking. Every bit of footage that we took, every bit of evidence that we gathered, we would turn over to the Canadian government. The first undercover footage that we gave resulted in sealers being convicted for a number of things, including skinning a seal alive.
My first trip out was in 2002. We were there just to look at the carcasses that were left behind. And the pilot took off and just left us. And there's this eerie silence once the helicopter goes. I remember laying down on the ice and shot this picture. And it's really eerie. It's horrible. It's just this rib cage sticking up. And it was, it was quite a moving moment.
Getting the footage is tough because a lot of people don't want to watch it. I know my mother won't watch it.
It's almost a catch-22. So much of the footage is so bad you can't show it on television.
IFAW's strategy had a flaw.
The challenge of this job is getting the image.
The sickening images don't run in the mainstream media.
The image that people will run in a magazine or a newspaper that people can stand to look at.
Only a certain type of picture will work.
Where you get that split second where the seal's looking up and the guy's just coming down with his club.
Let's face it, it's not pretty. The taking of any life is never pretty. The killing a pig, a cow, a sheep, a moose, the taking it out of its natural environment and killing it is never, ever a pretty sight. When there's a camera showing a seal on white ice with red blood and blue sky, that's quite an image. It's very effective, and people get emotional about that. You can't combat those images, but the reality is that's their abattoir. Take that camera and go into an abattoir and see how chickens are done, or go to a slaughterhouse where our cows are killed, and go look at that.
They brought the two parliamentarians to the ice to see the hunt firsthand.
And what was happening there, I mean, I will never forget.
I just can't understand. I would like you to explain to me how on earth it is possible for you to do that to the animals.
We have no
for
choice.
You to explain it.
You have no choice to do that.
You have no choice. I'm sorry. You have no choice. Nobody forces you.
You come out of my house and pay my bill for the next 30 years.
Do you feel like a hunter doing that?
Do I feel like a hunter?
Yeah.
I feel like a man that's trying to make a living.
It's just pocket money.
Oh, pocket money, yeah. Maybe for you guys.
It's all the money we have is pocket money.
We saw what was happening there. I mean, we were witnesses. I can assure you, I was really shocked.
A lot of times we see our seals that are clubbed, and we'll be watching it, and all of a sudden he'll raise his head and start crawling again. Once you realize that this animal's still alive, that's the most horrible thing that you can ever see.
What I see was the hell on ice. And so we came back to Belgium and we said, now is the time.
Took 40 years, but we got a bill introduced. I mean, all of a sudden, this is being discussed in Parliament.
I have to say, Canada's position on the seal hunt baffles me. It's Canadian government money that makes that hunt viable.
President, today my strong recommendation to this House.
I know no one who went to the ice and didn't come back against the hunt.
This little decision has the potential to devastate the families. I mean, you just don't go and destroy the life of these most vulnerable people and the industry that's very much needed. For some people sitting here in the warm seat, you know, getting, you know, fat salaries to decide about something they don't understand at all.
Die Abstimmung ist eröffnet.
Why would people vote against common sense? Just dogma, rhetoric, propaganda.
Insufficient information and one-sided.
I got upset about the misuse and abuse of science.
And I really believe that we can live in a healthy balance.
Blood-soaked ice everywhere.
If you've never hunted for your subsistence, you don't have any understanding.
Truly a bloodbath.
Seals are overabundant.
The double standards used by the EU.
I'm listening to the rhetoric.
There's a great bit of hypocrisy here that is.
Are you playing God? No.
Keeping on putting the pressure.
It's a statement based on ignorance, and it's simply
there's
not
no
true.
Economic justification.
Kind of an embarrassment. Why are we still doing this?
Baseless.
Hold on
baseless
to your wallet, because you're going to get taxed.
And that is not accurate at all.
That there's the facts, and then there's the spin on those facts.